through that all the sides of four numbers are equal. Okay, we are going to solve worksheet number 10. Okay, this is very simple theorem. Okay, here they have told us already the given quadrilateral is a rhombus. With the help of that given things, we have to prove all sides of rhombus are equal. Okay, so here first we will mention given. Okay, given. Rhombus, we can take a figure. ABCD is a rhombus. ABCD is a rhombus. Okay. So quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Rhombus means here we have to consider AB is equal to, in that AB is equal to CD. Okay, because here they have told us through that all sides of rhombus are equal. Okay, and we know that rhombus is also a parallelogram. Okay, so here we have to prove that. To prove AB, all sides are equal. AB is equal to BC, is equal to CD, is equal to AD, is equal to AD. Okay, so to prove AB, BC, CD, and AD are equal. So now, in proof, here they have already told us quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, and rhombus is also a parallelogram. Okay, so ABCD, quadrilateral ABCD is also a parallelogram. And parallelogram, what is the property of parallelogram? Opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. ABCD is a rhombus. We have considered that AB is equal to BC. Okay, but here ABCD is a parallelogram because rhombus is also parallelogram. So we can say AB is equal to CD and BC is equal to AD. Okay, because opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. But here AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC. This is given. Okay. So this I am saying this is first, this is second, and this is I am saying third one, which is given. Okay. AB and BC are equal. But AB and CD are equal. BC and AD are equal. So we can say with the help of first, second, and third, we can say AB is equal to BC, is equal to CD, is equal to AD. From 1, 1st, 2nd and 3rd. Okay, AB and BC are equal because this is a rhombus and rhombus is a parallelogram. In parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. So we can say AB, BC, CD and AD are equal. Okay, our second problem is ABCD is a rhombus with angle ABC is equal to 56 degree. Determine angle ACD. Okay, quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus, so diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Angle ABC, ABC, this is given 56 degree. Okay, so definitely this angle is 56 degree because this is rhombus, rhombus is a parallelogram. So this is very simple answer. So we can write first quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. So rhombus is a parallelogram. So quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. So in parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So we can say CDA or ADC, angle ADC is equal to 56. ADC is equal to 56. Okay. And this is the diagonal. Diagonal bisects the angle. Okay, so here we can say angle CDO. Angle CDO is equal to half of angle ADC. Okay, CDO is this angle. What we can find out this? Because we are asking angle ACD. ACD. We have to find out this angle. Okay. So now what we are going to do? We we will take half of this. This is 56 degrees. So angle CDO, CDO is equal to half of 56 degrees. So it will be 28 degrees. Half of 56 is 20. So this is 28 degrees. Okay. So now in this triangle OCD, in triangle OCD, okay, we can use angle sum property. That is OCD, angle OCD, OCD plus angle COD, angle COD plus angle ODC, ODC is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so OCD is unknown, COD is 90 degree. So angle OCD plus 90 degree plus that angle is ODC is 28 degree. Is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so angle OCD is equal to 180 degree minus 90 plus 20. 90 plus 28 is 108 degree. So 180 minus 108 degree will be 62 degree. OCD is equal to 60 degree. They are asking ACD. OCD and ACD is same. So we can write directly here angle OCD is equal to angle ACD is equal to 62 degrees. Okay, so this is the answer of second question. Okay, next problem is that is very simple. PQRS is a square. PR and SQ intersect at O. State the measure of angle Q. Okay, so we know that the diagonals of square are intersecting each other at right angle. So definitely here it is given 90 degree. So they are asking POQ. POQ is also 90 degree. So this is very simple answer. Okay. Okay. See here our next problem is ABCD is a rhombus. Show that diagonal AC bisects angle A as well as angle C. And diagonal BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. Okay, so first what is given? Quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, rhombus means all the sides are equal. So that property we are going to use in the proof. Now what we have to prove? First it is given that diagonal AC bisects angle A and angle C. Okay, second diagonal is BD. Diagonal BD bisects angle B and angle D. Okay, so now in proof we are going to use this triangle. First triangle ADC or any triangle we can use. From that I am taking here in triangle ADC AD is equal to DC, because this is a rhombus, so all the sides are equal in length. So we can say AD and DC are equal. Okay, so all sides are equal. Because they have told us this is a rhombus, so AD and DC are equal. If AD and DC are equal, we can say DAC is equal to DCA. Angle DAC is equal to angle DCA. Okay, DAC, base angles, angles opposite of equal sides. DAC is equal to DCA. So here we can write angles opposite of equal sides. Angles opposite of equal sides are always. Now AD and BC are parallel. AD and BC are parallel because this is a parallelogram. Rhombus is also parallel. So we can see here AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC and AC is a transversal. AC is a transversal. Okay. AD parallel to BC, AC is a transversal. So we can say DAC angle DAC is equal to, DAC is equal to angle BCA, angle BCA, alternate angles, DAC, this and this angle is equal to this, but these two angles are equal. So this is, I am saying, this is first one and this is second one. Okay, so from first and second we can say BAC is equal to BCA, DAC is equal to BCA, so we can say angle BCA is equal to angle BCA. So this is, I am saying, third one, this will be from first and second. Okay, DCA is equal to BCA, these two angles are equal. So diagonal AC bisects angle C, diagonal AC bisects angle C. Now we are going to think about angle A. Okay, so now remaining part we will see here, that is here. Now we will think about triangle. In triangle ABC, AB is equal to BC because rhombus, all the sides are equal. AB and BC are equal. So BAC, angle BAC is equal to angle BCA, angles opposite of equal sides. Opposite of equal sides. Okay, angles opposite of equal sides are same. So BAC is equal to BAC is equal to BCA. So this is, I am saying, this is third one. This is third one. Okay. So here we have BCA and here also we have BCA. So from third, this is fourth one. This is fourth one. For here we can write fourth. Okay. So from third and fourth, from third and fourth, we can say BCA, here also we have BCA, and there also we have BCA. So angle BCA, angle BCA is equal to angle BAC. BCA is equal to BAC. But BCA is what? BAC. Okay? Because these two sides are equal and we have sides are equal and angles opposite of equal sides. So here we have told that. Okay. So now BCA we will replace by BAC. Angle BAC is equal to angle BAC. BAC and BAC. BAC is this angle and BAC is this angle. Okay. So AC, diagonal AC bisects angle A and C. Diagonal AC bisects angle A as well as angle C, like angle A as well as angle C. Okay, so this way we can give proof for second diagonal, that is diagonal B. The same proof will come. Now we need to think about that diagonal and these two triangles. Okay, thank you.